Today we're going to be talking about how we're able to tell whether or not we tolerate sound doctrine. We're going to be using the text 2 Timothy 4, 2 through 5 to sort of get us going on this idea of, do we tolerate sound doctrine or sound teaching? 2 Timothy 4, verses 2 through 5. Preach the word, be ready in season and out of season. Rebuke, correct, and encourage with great patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but according to their own desires, will multiply teachers for themselves, because they have an itch to hear what they want to hear. They will turn away from hearing the truth, and will turn aside to myths. But as for you, exercise self-control in everything, endure hardship, do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. So this text is sort of like twofold. It's meant for the church, the body of believers, those who identify as Christians, those who are Jesus followers. And it's meant to tell them, you know, be cautious, be aware, not because necessarily peripherally everyone around you, right? But me. We have to keep ourselves in check to make sure that we're tolerating sound doctrine. When we hear texts like this, when we hear warnings like this, we always make it external. It's always about like everybody around us. It's also for the secular world, or for the world without faith. It's sort of like a premonition to let us know there's going to come a time. It's not just going to be in the church. It's they multiply teachers for themselves because they have an itch to hear what they want to hear. First, have to look at ourselves. Second, look externally. I got three questions we can ask ourselves. Do I believe the truth? Or do I simply believe what I want to believe? Are you willing to believe things that you dislike because they're true? You hear people say, I could never believe in a God that allows evil. I could never believe in a God that allows suffering. I could never believe in a God that created us to die. So what they're saying is, even if that were true, I just wouldn't believe it. I just don't like it. Don't decide what you'll believe ahead of time. We believe something because it's true. Hopefully there's naturalistic atheists and agnostics that watching this video and they say, Aaron, don't you believe in the biggest fairy tale of all? I think that's a fair question. I'm going to answer that question with just some of the things that I believe as a follower of Jesus, as someone who believes that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. I believe Philippians 2:3, do nothing out of selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, consider others as more important than yourself. Look, I don't like that. I don't want to believe that. Secondly, Galatians 5:13. For you were called to be free, brothers and sisters, only don't use this freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but serve one another through love. Come on, man. No, I'm trying to serve myself, right? Very difficult thing. Third, John 15:13, no one has greater love than this, to lay down his life for his friends. That's how I gauge love. Am I laying my life down for my friends? Am I loving my wife the way that Christ loved the church, that he laid his life down for her? Difficult. Fourth, 2 Corinthians 5:10, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may be repaid for what he has done in the body, whether good or evil. Romans 14:12. So then, each of us will give an account of himself to God. That's not super appealing. That's not something I'm like, hey, you know what I want to believe? I want to believe that I'm just living this life so that I can give an account of what I have done with it. Not appealing. Ephesians 2:8. For you are saved by grace through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is God's gift. Of all these things that are expected, that are the target of God. These are God's target for humankind. And they don't come natural. They're not appealing. And I don't really want to do them. I mean, you really think this is what I want to believe? Do I believe the truth? Or do I simply believe what I want to believe? The caveat to this is that just believing things that are hard to believe doesn't make them true. I acknowledge that. All right, number two. Second question. What do you want? What's your motive? What's your desire? Do you want to be above others? Do you want to be liked? Do you want to fit in? Do you want to stand out? Do you want to be right? Do you want to know the secret? Do you want to have the answer? Do you want to ask the question? Do you want to lead? Do you want to be heard? Do you want to be involved? Do you want to be known? Or do you want God? If we're not aiming at God, if we're not aiming at loving God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, we're going to branch off onto all of these other roads. And all of these other roads corrupt your motive. And they corrupt your ability to be unbiased in deciphering whether or not you're tolerating truth. Our bias is shaped and formed on what our motive is. So let your bias be shaped and formed on your motive being truth, not your bias to the truth. And then the third and last question that I have is, do you exchange truth for lies? Well, how are we to gauge that? How are we to know? The scripture in verse 4 here says that you turn away from the truth, the aletheia, and you turn towards the myth, the mouthos. And the myth is a fiction, a fable, an invention, a falsehood, a narrative, or a story. Start looking at our worldviews. Are we believing in myths? Do you know that it's true that nothing cannot make something? Yet, are you allowing an invention to explain that it can? Do you know that there's right and wrong, yet you allow a narrative of naturalism to explain away right and wrong? Do you sense that you have a soul? Without external influence, do you just sense that you have a soul? Does this thing just kind of ring true? And yet, do you allow that natural intuition to be overruled by external voices? Do you sense that love and hate are beyond the material world? Do you have this inexplicable sense, year after year, that you're not where you're supposed to be? Do I believe the truth, or do I believe what I want to believe? What do I want? Do I exchange the truth for a lie? Big bang, 6 to 7. Hey, hey, the king, the legend. Big bang, the truth, the weapon. Hey, hey.